Valence bond theory describes the overlap of valence electrons between two atoms. The two atoms are bound via the sharing of the electrons to produce covalent bonds and leading to covalent molecules with characteristic electronic geometries. Now, you may remember that we previously learned that an isolated atom has its electrons arranged in orbitals in a way that leads to the lowest total energy for the atom. We called that the ground state electron configuration, and we learned a way to characterize that ground state electron configuration using the electron orbital notation, 1s1, 1s2, 2s1, etc., to, in a shorthand way, show where the electrons are in the ground state configurations. The valence bond theory helps us move from isolated atoms, the location of electrons in the valence shell of isolated atoms, to the location of electrons in covalently bound molecules. First of all, let's think of the simplest situation, the H2 molecule. Think first of the electron configuration of the ground state for a hydrogen atom. It is 1s1. One electron in the 1s subshell. We can think of the covalent bond being formed as the two atoms move down an axis towards each other to some optimum distance where the energy is minimized. In this case, we say we are now sharing electrons between the two atoms and we formed a covalent bond. According to valence bond theory, we now have the electrons in a new low energy state different than the pure 1s orbitals. And in this situation, when the electrons are shared, according to the valence bond theory, we say that there's been head-on overlap between the two isolated s orbitals to give a sigma bond. Okay, a sigma bond. It's a new term that's used widely to describe these covalent bonds. Take a look at another simple molecule, HF, the diatomic molecule hydrogen fluoride. The electron configuration for hydrogen, of course, is 1s1. And in this case, since this is the valence bond theory, we only have to consider the electron configuration of the valence orbital. So for fluorine, since the valence shell is the second energy level, the electron configuration is 2s2, 2p5. All right, and in this case, all the electrons are paired up except for one in a 2p orbital. Let's call it the 2pz orbital, just for the sake of argument. So if you go back to this image and think of the hydrogen atom approaching the fluorine atom down some axes, let's choose the z axis in this case, and you think of the shapes of those individual atomic orbitals. Of course, the s is just a sphere, and the p's are each a dumbbell shape along a different axis. So if we assume that this is the p shape orbital with one electron in it, coming down, meeting the hydrogen 1s orbital head on, then we've created a new bond in which the two electrons are shared at some optimum distance between the two nuclei, and we formed yet again a sigma bond. There is an overlap of the two pure atomic orbitals, giving us a sigma bond. It correctly predicts what we see in the case of the formation of this simple single bond between hydrogen and fluoride. And you can think of the fact that it's geometrically possible for these two individual pure atomic orbitals to overlap to give what we see as the hydrogen fluoride molecule. So for simple diatomic molecules, the valence bond theory correctly predicts the overlap of electrons found in the pure atomic orbitals. However, in most cases, the pure atomic orbitals don't have the correct energies or orientations to accurately predict the observed molecular geometries. So in the next short video, we'll take a look at how pure atomic orbitals are hybridized to form new orbitals, allowing for the correct predicted and experimentally determined geometries.